Hi, my name is Jack Barnell. I'm the Emotional Orphan. I'd like to welcome you to the Social Yet Distance podcast, where we'll tackle topics such as poetry, literature, small press, book releases, politics, mental health, a whole wide variety of topics, just about anything. And we look forward to you coming and visiting with us on a weekly basis. We hope to have one, two, or three podcasts a week up, and to get a YouTube channel going in conjunction with it. So we look forward to seeing you. Thanks for joining us on the Social Yet Distance podcast.
Hi, baby, it's me. I'm driving to work. If I don't talk to you, I'll just talk to you this evening when I get off. It'll be late, so I love you very much, and I will talk to you later. Love you. Bye.
Hey there. I'd like to do a poem tonight by somebody that I consider to be my spiritual poetry brother, Mr. A. Razor. Those of you that have read Razor's work will be excited to know that there's a new book out. It's called Puro Purismo. It's been released by Punk Hostage Press, the label that Razor and Iris Berry started about 9 years ago. Happy anniversary, Punk Hostage Press. And Razor and I have been friends for a long, long time, and I'm going to read this piece called Deep End. Deep end. Thrown in for kicks or jumped in for fun. It doesn't matter. Now it's time to swim or swallow. Keep the head above the surface. Kick for all it's worth. Paddle like crazy. Do whatever it takes to keep from sinking. Do it quickly or sink. Swim or swallow. Keep the head above the surface. The bottom is far below. The safety of dry land does not seem safe enough to move towards it yet. This just might be what it's all about. This might be what it's called for, whether you were thrown in or if you actually jumped. It doesn't matter. Swim or swallow. Keep the head above the surface if you ever want to make it out of the deep end again. Deep End, A. Razor. Puro Purismo, released by Punk Hostage Press. Go and pick up a copy. Thanks. At the Social Yet Distanced, we believed in maintaining good relations with ourselves and with others. The world is changing, and the modalities towards health are morphing back into an inner, more ancient form of understanding. How we treat our temple, how we treat our minds, how we treat others around us are of paramount importance. We're becoming more focused on alternatives, and when we find them, we share them. Our friends Corinne and her compadre Nikki are delivering a system to learn, educate, and share that healing with the world. You decide if you want to do it in order to make a living, or if you want to do it in order to make the living, as in living at the maximum. Come find out how at CCI, the Cannabis Coaching Institute, at cannabiscoachinginstitute.com. Okay, guys, let's get to it. On today's episode, we're going to basically walk through the various components of the social yet distance world. A little bit about who we are, where we came from, what we're doing, what the goals are, and some of the tools that we already have in place. Even if you just listen to the podcast, there's a lot going on there that you probably aren't aware of. So you know, I wanted to take a minute to point these things out and kind of explain how all the components fit together and where the opportunities may lie for other artists or small press or writers, poets, anybody with a story to tell. So we are looking at the front page of the anchor.fm/emotionalorphan website. It is the central hub house for the Social Yet Distanced podcast. Looking at this page, it's really the only difference from the public facing page is the new episode button and the ability to access the settings. As you walk down the page, you'll see a listen on Spotify button. Anchor, the podcaster, has a relationship with Spotify, which actually works on our behalf. It gives us some access to music that's not royalty free, but it's been licensed through Spotify. So it's legal for us to use some things along the way that we might not have had access to. And in addition to that, you see, it's basically a button. You just click it and it'll open Spotify and go directly to the page on Spotify for the podcast itself, where you can subscribe and rate and rank and tell your grandmother and whatever else is made available through their app at any given time. So that's that. If you move to the right there, you'll see a button with a dollar sign that strikes most people's attention. That is a support button. And if you're familiar with membership-based sites like Patreon, Buy Me a Coffee, other tools out there that allow the public to subscribe to a particular artistic or content creators, we offer that as well. I'll talk a little bit more about that. In addition to the support that we have available, the support options that we have available, we also have do earn advertising dollars on sponsorships that are provided through through Anchor. We currently have one spot running. I've got a couple that I recorded for friends, and as our audience grows, we'll have other opportunities come across the pipeline for ongoing sponsorships, as well as doing outreach with additional opportunities for funding the project through advertising dollars as well. We're not in a hurry to do that. We're not in a hurry to push the support, but we do need to generate the resources to support the production of the podcast itself and, the ancillary services that we provide. The next button is a message button. That button is pretty cool, and it's going to come in handy later. That if you click that button, it allows you to leave a 60-second voice message. I foresee using that as a way of communicating with the audience. It also serves as a way for us to do contests and competitions and giveaways and that kind of thing. For example, put a keyword, a code word hidden in every podcast. And if you subscribe to the podcast and you get the keyword and match it up, you win a prize, whatever the case might be. But that's kind of how we envision all of that with the main page from the anchor.fm website. In addition, we are listed on, at least on this page, five other additional podcast resources. Spotify, our RSS feed pumps into a couple of different websites out there, so it's updated as we post new content. And several of the other podcast aggregators out there as well, including TuneIn, which is probably the biggest for online radio/TV content, and of course Google and Apple. So that's that page. Okay, so I wanted to jump over and show you what it looked like on the mobile app. This is just a picture from my phone, a screenshot, and you can see the layout's basically the same. I did not mention the social media buttons down there do link to the existing social media for the social yet distance, and as well as to the worksite in progress. The following page is the support button from the main page. The support button, if you click this button, it's going to give you some information about who we are and what our mission is. And then three different levels available to support the podcast itself and the Arts Collective. We've settled on these numbers. We haven't quite identified and labeled exactly what the premiums are going to be. We have started two separate merch stores that I'll show you a little bit later. So some of the gifts and prizes will come from merch, as well as maybe publishing a book or a broadside of a poem that you, maybe you submit through the contest button, the message button, that kind of thing. There are a lot of options for us to do this. It's not a high priority right this minute, but there are opportunities. Go ahead and get involved, and we will lay out what the premium is going to be and let everybody know at that point. And we'll talk a little bit more about the rest in a minute. Today's public service announcement. Don't be a lame flame. It's been done already. And speaking of Los Angeles traditions, the Social Yet Distance podcast is lovingly supported by Punk Rock Hostage Press. Punk rock sentiments in words. We send a happy 9-year anniversary to Punk Hostage Press, its founders, editors, and all the authors. We'd like to thank you for walking us through our transition from Van Halen to X by way of the Go-Go's. Fueled by a flurry of recent releases from 2020 into 2021, Punk Hostage Press has used three recent releases to lead the forefront. Dan Denton has released his $100 a week motel, Nadia Bruce Rawlings, Driving in the Rain, and hopefully Nadia will be here with us soon, and then A Razor's long-awaited Puro Purismo. Come visit punkhostagepress.com for access to a library of work from the finest small press writers ever. punkhostagepress.com. Okay, so the next part of our little project here is the social media. We are pretty well covered in the social media realm for the moment. There are some changes that we'd like to make, and we need to better learn how to use some of the tools that are available. But we are doing that as well and moving forward in those directions. What you don't see here on this page, we have the Redbubble and Society 6 page. They're both at /Emotional Orphan. Those are the merchandise stores, and I'll show you a couple of pictures of them here in a minute. The Anchor FM Emotional Orphan page is this podcast page. We have an Instagram, which is housed underneath my personal Instagram at Emotional Orphan. There's a Twitter account at SDistanced and Facebook at Social Yet Distanced as well. So those sites are available. There is a YouTube channel as well that is a playlist off of my main channel. Part of the reason we've held back on some of these changes is simply because there's some expense involved, and we need to do some more testing and a major launch to a little bit more accurately measure what our audience is going to be and what the needs are going to be for that audience. So that's the social media aspects of it. If we talk about merchandise, We have two shops, one at Redbubble and one at Society 6. Redbubble focuses a little bit more on clothing and prints, you know, face masks, that kind of thing. With these designs, there's approximately 75 or so different products that are available. And then there's also a secondary site, which I'll show you as well. But, you know, the Society 6 site includes some really different type of merchandise that we can use for logo merchandise or giveaways or whatever the case might be. They're a little bit more art focused, and like there's furniture and sunshades and some things that are really different than your average merchandise. So that's pretty cool as well. We'll be adding to all of those collections to include broadsides that we print through the Social Yet Distance podcast and our engines, and we'll continue to add to those, as well as actively work in the social media streams. There is a Facebook account. If I mention, please go and like us. Please make sure you follow the podcast and any of the other social media. Please add your name as well. And the most important thing anybody can do is share our name and where we are so that we can build the audience. One of the unspoken goals of Social Yet Distance is, you know, I looked around and I realized I've got a lot of artist friends, a lot of writer friends, and we all tend to close ourselves off in these circles of people who are all doing the exact same thing that we're doing. So I write a book and I put it out there and it's available for people to buy, and I'm promoting that book to a bunch of writers who are also writing books that they're trying to promote to a bunch of writers. So the idea that we're hoping to accomplish here is to take art, words, poetry, literature, whatever the case might be, and spread those good things out there into the universe and into audiences that may or may not have actually been exposed to the arts in the way that we have. So that's how the social media is going to work with that. One of the things that we have discovered and added as part of our package here is the website Gumroad. I've had an account with Gumroad for years and really kind of forgot about it. And looking for products and services and things to offer our audience, I went back and took a look, and they've really upgraded their platform and ease of use and the ability to sell books and, well, let's just say digital items via their format. So what that's going to do is offer an opportunity for writers who want to self-publish to go through the Social Yet Distance framework and basically submit documents to us, and we can do the formatting and upload them and sell them. It is, at this stage of the game, strictly a digital format. So the bonus there is that for folks who are strictly offering a print version of their book, we can offer additional formats if that's something that they want to pursue. We're not looking to make any money doing this. This is not a service we're marketing actively. But we are wanting people to know that the platform is out there, and we are willing to discuss opportunities to highlight the publisher or the writer's work and make that work available to the audience that we build through Gumroad. In addition, we see it as another opportunity to do some things that are kind of different. For example, if you were to hit the message button from the main podcast website and leave a 1-minute poem in for a competition, maybe something we could do as in order to entice that competition or that contest and to bring in the audience for that would be to have a contest, and whoever wins, we design and make available a print of that broadside, and of course an author's copy and that kind of thing for any projects that we're involved in. So that's some of our thoughts about Gumroad. If you take a look here, this is kind of the main page. I took these screenshots. You can do it from the web, but I took these from the screenshots within their app. They do have an app as well as you can pretty much do whatever you want from gumroad.com. This is my personal page. I'm in the process of changing the name to the Social Yet Distance. I haven't gotten a response back, but hopefully we'll be able to get that taken care of here in the next week or so. What you see here is my profile, my name, how to get a hold of me, a place to subscribe so that you're notified if we release new documents, new publications. This is a copy of a chapbook that I wrote, God knows, I don't even know, probably 2004, 2005, and it's available in a digital format. In some things, for example, the broadsides, what we would do would be an extra high resolution version, transmit that to you, and then you could simply print it and frame it, or even take it to, you know, a more professional printer and have it done in on Canvas or whatever the case might be. So a lot of different options available. Our stores at Redbubble and Society 6 could do the same thing as well. And, you know, for example, print it on bamboo if that's what you wanted. So lots of options there, and a way to unify the use of those tools, like the message button, like the support buttons, as well as tools and platforms that we have access to, like Gumroad, which will process the payments for us and that kind of thing. So it's a pretty robust system and platform for where it is right now. We've got a lot of work to do. The main thing we're trying to accomplish at this point is to bring in the audience and to educate that audience on who we are and what we do, provide some excellent content, and offer ongoing opportunities for engagement. If you look at this page, this will give you a second look at a different page. Empire Dirt is another couple of chat books that I did. I did a test. I took some existing poems, did a pretty quick curation for two books, grabbed some of my artwork for the covers, and threw these books together in about an hour in production time, and then uploaded them, and they were available. So probably start to finish, it was an hour and a half for me to get three chat books and a broadside, which is right here, published, all of those things published in about an hour and a half. So it's pretty quick and easy, down and dirty. I think if I keep playing with it, I'll learn it pretty well. And I think that we can generate a lot of interest in this particular tool. And if nothing else, we've educated friends and family about another platform that's out there that might be helpful in their own writing and content creation world. So that's that. Gumroad is, I kind of say that for last. I consider that to be the best for last. It's one of the components that I think will provide the most payoff and the most reward for everybody involved. And again, it's one of those tools that will help us to spread the message outside of our own little closed-in silos of commonality, and reach out into some audiences that need to hear what it is that we have to offer, need to see the art that we're creating, need to hear the message and the stories that we're trying to tell. So that's what we're hoping to do. We hope that you'll join us in the process. We appreciate you taking the time to listen and walk through, and please dig around on all these sites. You will see links to all of them pretty much from the Facebook page. And like I said, it's Instagram, Twitter, Facebook. We've got the Gumroad site. There's a YouTube site. And then the anchor.fm/emotionalorphan podcast. We appreciate you guys coming by. Thanks. Good night. Hello, my name is Jack Varnell. I'm the Emotional Orphan. I am with the Social Yet Distance podcast. And, you know, in this crazy COVID world that we've created, everybody is always looking for ways to support themselves and their families. So that's what the Social Yet Distance podcast and crew is really all about. We're built on the idea of supporting small businesses, the small press, and all the creators we can get our hands on. We're looking at ways that we can bring you more and better content that helps us to meet that goal. But meanwhile, redbubble.com and society6.com/emotionalorphan at both. We'll get you to our art store and merchandise store where you can pick up all kind of goodies, anything from art to full-size furniture. So come visit us. Help support the podcast.